Delegates, as we have seen in the video where we talked about the skeleton of the debate, we differentiated between the formal debate and the informal debate. In a formal debate, there is a GSL going on till the end of the debate, and there is informal debate which diverges from the formal debate. Now, when does a delegate get a chance to enter into an informal debate? Now, delegates, this is a discretion given to the executive board. When the executive board feels that the delegates have debated, you know, sufficiently on the given topic, the executive board members ask that, is there any point on the floor? If the executive board sees none, they proceed to ask to the delegates any motions on the floor. Now, at this point, a delegate can raise motions to diversify the debate from formal to informal debate. Now, when we are talking about the moderated caucus, a delegate in the given verbatim can always raise a moderated caucus. Now, the verbatim is that, so if I am the delegate of Switzerland, then I will raise my placard after the executive board has mentioned or asked for any motions on the floor. I'll raise my placard after the executive board recognizes me. In the verbatim which follows right now, I will raise a motion for a moderated caucus. The verbatim being, the delegate of Switzerland would like to suspend the formal debate and enter into a moderated caucus for the subtopic XYZ for the total time period 10 minutes and per speaker time 60 seconds. Now, these are the 3 to 4 components of this verbatim. So what the delegate does first, it is he suspends the formal debate. Then he suggests a topic for the moderated caucus, which is the subtopic, which can be a sub agenda of the agenda which is going to be discussed for 2 days. Then he mentions the total time for the moderated caucus, which cannot exceed more than 20 minutes. And the last is he states the per speaker time. So naturally, when I say the total time is 10 minutes and the per speaker time is 60 seconds, we have the place for 10 speakers in that moderated caucus. So 10 speakers can have a chance to speak in the moderated caucus. And then after the moderated caucus is done, after the 10th speech of the moderated caucus is done, the debate automatically resumes to the general speaker's list. There is no other motion to take the debate back to the general speaker's list. Here's one more thing, is extension to the moderated caucus. Now, extension to the moderated caucus can be raised if the committee members feel that the subtopic of the motion has not been debated thoroughly and they need more speaker spaces. So what a delegate can do is after the last speech, he can raise a placard. If the executive board asks voluntarily, then well and good. But if not, after the last the speech of the moderated caucus, the delegate can raise a placard and then to raise a motion for extending the present moderated caucus by 5 minutes. Now, if the moderated caucus's time is 10 minutes in total, the extension can only be limited to 50% of the given total time. One more thing about moderated caucus is that the delegate who raises the moderated caucus gets an opportunity to be either the first speaker or the last speaker. Once that motion is taken in order and voted upon, then the executive board asks the delegate and should ask the delegate whether he would like to be the first speaker or the last speaker in the delegate, and thus the moderated caucus proceeds. Thank you.